What's up, my YouTube family? Sergeant Greybeard back with another Division 2 video. Today is Thursday, March 25th, and as always, I hope this message finds you healthy and safe. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to get the exotic SMG, the Chatterbox. Now, many of you have recently reached out to the channel. You're either new players or players just returning who never got this weapon before. You are asking how do you get the components, the blueprints, so that is exactly what I'm going to show you today. Now, if you happen to be new here, first of all, welcome. Secondly, feel free to hit that subscribe button. We would love for you to be a part of our gaming family. And if you enjoyed this or found it helpful at all, take a quick second and hit that like button. It really, really helps the channel out. So the first thing I want to cover in the video today has to do with Hyena keys. Now you need to have these keys in order to open Hyena lockboxes, which is the only place you're going to find the exotic components for the Chatterbox. Now, thankfully, you now have different options in the game on how to get these keys. I'm a day one player, and back in the day, back in my day, all we could do was run around underground in these tunnels and hope a key dropped out of one of those lockboxes. Now, thankfully, this is still a viable option to get keys. However, one thing to keep in mind is if you're farming this way, when you go to these boxes, there's no guarantee it's going to be a Hyena key. It could be True Sons, it could be, you know, Outcast, any one of the factions, one of those keys could pop out. The other thing I want to mention is that these boxes are on a 24-hour timer. So the box I just opened a moment ago, I will not be able to open that specific box for 24 hours after I've opened the first one. So you want to make sure you keep that in mind when you're using this method. One recommendation I'd like to pass along is you should try to have at least 3 or 4 Hyena keys in your inventory at all times, because the last thing you want to happen is come across a Hyena cache and not be able to open it. Having said that, now thankfully you can also get keys from Hyena bounties. Now I'm at shade level 6, so I don't have too many bounties on my map as yet. However, as you progress in the game, you're going to get more and more bounties, so always keep that in mind. Now the best way about farming for keys in this fashion is the fact that every Hyena bounty you face will drop a key. So that way, if you have 3 or 4 you can hit up on a daily basis, you're guaranteed to get those keys, which you can stockpile, which will really help out. Another option you have if you are a new player, you don't have too many keys, you know, in your inventory, you can also use random matchmaking for those Hyena missions, because they will have exotic caches in them and hopefully another player has a key and they'll open up those for you. I actually have an example of that in this video, so you'll be able to check that out. Now, the final thing I want to mention is I was really, really lucky. You're going to see me get all of these components between shade level 6 and shade level 7. Now, when I first got this weapon, it literally took me weeks and weeks to get all this stuff. Therefore, I want to remind you, as always, it's all RNG. I know my first experience getting this gun was much different than this one right here, so now we're going to get into the details. So the first component you're going to look for is in the Grand Washington Hotel mission. There happen to be 2 Hyena lockboxes in this mission, the first of which is right here. You're going to, once you take out those NPCs, you're going to go into a little bathroom here. You're going to see one of the boxes. Now, in this instance, you'll see I opened it up, and unfortunately, there was no component there. However, when I get to the second Hyena cache, which is right before you face Saint, which is the final boss in this mission, I open it up. Thankfully, the loaded canister was there, and this is the first of 3 components I need to put the SMG together. And one thing I'd like to mention as we move on is for these 3 components that you need, you can get them in any order whatsoever. Right now, we're at Jefferson Trade Center, which is another spot you're going to find a component. This was actually the first one that I picked up. Now, a moment ago, I referenced another agent opening up a cache and hopefully the exotic component popping out. You can see here that's exactly what happened. So once again, if you're low on keys, you play in a group, just matchmake for Jefferson Trade Center, Grand Washington Hotel, and hopefully you can get lucky. Now, in regards to the third component, you're going to find that in a Hyena lockbox in the open world. Now, there are multiple ones across the map. You'll see here in a second, I'm going to show you where I found mine, but any Hyena cache can have this in it. And this, my friends, is where luck just comes into play. It's all RNG, and like I mentioned a moment ago, for my Xbox character, when this game first came out, it took me weeks and weeks of farming nonstop to finally get this thing. It was much more of a grind, but this time I just got really lucky. Now moving on to the final step, my friends. So once you've gotten those 3 components, and again, you can get them in any order you want, the final step you make is going to Bank Headquarters mission. You're going to take out the named boss Rebound, and once you do, you're going to pick up the key that he drops. Once you pick up the key, you're going to make your way into the office, go straight ahead, and up against the wall, just get close to this little panel right there. You're going to then be prompted to open the panel. Inside is an RFID card. You're going to pick that up, and that will gain you access to the safe. And once again, my friends, just to be clear, you cannot get the Chatterbox blueprint until you have the other three components. So if you don't have those three components, no matter how many times you hit up this cache, the blueprint will not drop. Having said that, you'll see in a second, I was lucky enough to get the blueprint to drop, and all of this took me about an hour and a half total. Now, as I mentioned before, it took me dozens of hours to get the weapon on my other character, so again, be patient because this thing is definitely worth the grind. Now that you have all three components, you have the blueprint, you're going to make your way to the base of operations, you're going to go to your crafting bench, and you'll be able to craft the Chatterbox. Now all you'll do is open up weapons, you're going to scroll down to exotics, and you'll see at that point you can finally craft the SMG. And one thing I'd like to mention as I start to wrap this video up is, in my opinion, the most important thing you do is after you craft this weapon, mark it as a favorite so you don't accidentally deconstruct it. The reason I bring this up is because I have made that mistake before and it totally sucks. I've heard from a lot of you out there, you've made that mistake as well. You know, you're going through your inventory, you're not paying attention, you're deconstructing things or marking them as junk. So once you mark something as a favorite, you cannot accidentally deconstruct it. For those of you that may not know how to do that, all you do is go to the weapon, you click on it. At that point, you're going to press the right trigger button. That is for Xbox or PlayStation. You'll see a prompt where it says mark as favorite, and then you're good to go. Finally, my friends, I want to once again remind you that the lockbox is where you'll find the keys, and the hyena caches themselves are on the 24-hour timer, so always keep that in mind anytime you're farming. On that note, I'm going to wrap this video up. As always, I want to take a moment and thank you all for your continued support. This is a video I've actually wanted to do for a while. I haven't really had time to make a new character, but with getting the PS5, I was able to, and I absolutely love the fact I could finally bring you this video. Many of you have reached out to the channel asking me to put together a build video for the Chatterbox. I will definitely be doing that soon. However, I wanted to put this together to show those of you that may not have the weapon how to get it, so that way when I put the build video together, you can hopefully make one yourself. Like I mentioned at the beginning of this thing, if you happen to be new here, feel free to hit that subscribe button. We would love for you to be a part of our gaming family. If you enjoyed this, you could hit that like button as well. But most importantly, take care of yourselves, be kind to each other, and we will talk to you soon. Thanks again, everyone.